In New Motion Professional, you can use inverse kinematics, or short IK, to manipulate a bone chain by moving its endpoint. That way, you can, for example, manipulate the whole arm of a human-like character just by dragging the hand. In the traditional forward kinematics approach, it is always necessary to manipulate every bone in the chain to get the endpoint to the desired position. So in order to get the hand to a desired position, it is always necessary to rotate the upper arm and the forearm. Inverse kinematics is part of the constraint system. It's worth noting that constraints are baked into the final animation. U-Motion offers no solution for in-game inverse kinematics. Setting up inverse kinematics can be done manually or since U-Motion 1.2 by using the IK Setup Wizard. The IK Setup Wizard can be opened by clicking the appropriate button in config mode. When the wizard is opened for the first time, the character's forward direction needs to be configured. Check the arrow displayed in the scene view. If it is not pointing forward from the character's perspective, rotate the arrow until its direction is correct. The IK Setup Wizard is split into two parts. It has one section to set up IK for human-like characters and one for creating any kind of custom IK. Every setting of the IK constraint can be set from within the wizard. The meaning of these settings will be covered later in this tutorial when we manually create an IK constraint. Saving the settings made in the wizard as a preset allows using the same IK setup across multiple U-Motion projects. When the current project is of type humanoid, the human IK section of the wizard is already filled out completely. Thus, all that needs to be done is clicking on Create, and the IK rig is automatically created and ready to be used. For more information regarding the IK wizard, please check out the appropriate section in the manual. It is also possible to create IK rigs manually. This is especially useful when creating more complex IK rigs. The first thing that needs to be done is to create a custom transform, which is going to be used as IK handle. The IK handle position is used as the target position by the IK constraint. In this example, we will set up inverse kinematics for the right arm. Switch to config mode, select the hand bone and add a custom joint at the center. In the properties tab, rename the joint to something meaningful. Make it a custom transform and slightly increase its size for better visibility. The created IK handle currently is a child of the right hand. This is not allowed as the IK constraint will rotate the arm to reach the handle position, but rotating the arm effectively also moves the handle, which results in a new target position for the IK constraint, and so on. So this would be a circular dependency. Thus, it is not allowed that any parent bone of the IK handle are affected by its IK constraint. It depends on the situation which parent bone to choose for the IK handle. Setting the parent to be the root game object will make the hand bone stay at the same position even when the whole body is moved. When using the hips as a parent bone, the hand will move with the body. In this example, we will select the root game object to be the parent. Next, we will add the inverse kinematics constraint to the IK handle. The target is the endpoint in the bone chain, in our case, the wrist of the right hand. The chain length is the number of bones that should be controlled by the IK constraint. In our case, the forearm and the upper arm should be controlled. Thus, the default value of 2 is okay. Bones that are affected by an IK constraint are displayed in blue. In the last step, we need to set up the IK plane. Make the plane point into the same direction as the elbow should bend. The IK constraint will rotate the elbow only alongside the surface of the plane. To make it point into the correct direction, click on front and then on inverse. And that's it. The arm is now set up correctly. Let's switch to pose mode to test it. Select the IK handle and move it with the move tool. You should see that the bones are following the IK handle. Your motion has two rig layers that allow you to combine the forward kinematics approach with the inverse kinematics approach. Think of it as if the animated character has two skeletons, one controlled by forward kinematics and one controlled by inverse kinematics. The final pose of the mesh is mixed by the FK-IK blend channel that is available for each IK handle. Like any other channel, the FK-IK blend channel can be keyed, thus making it possible to seamlessly blend between forward and inverse kinematics during an animation clip. With the IK pole rotation channel, it is possible to rotate the whole arm around its pole axis. The pole axis starts at the shoulder and points into the direction of the hand. Sometimes it is useful to use a dedicated pole target instead. Therefore, we create a new custom transform at the elbow and move it slightly behind. After setting up its properties, we assign it to the IK constraint as pole target. The pole target rotates the arm in such a way that the IK plane, or effectively the elbow, always points towards the pole target. Back in pose mode, we can use the pole target to rotate the arm. By default, the IK constraint uses the reference pose as reference. That means that before applying the IK algorithm, the arm is reset into the reference pose defined in config mode. It is also possible to use the current forward kinematics pose as reference. As the IK algorithm usually tries to reach the IK handle position by rotating at one of the shortest paths from its start pose, the reference has great influence on the end result the IK constraint produces. Thus, using the forward kinematics pose as reference gives you very fine-graded control over the end result the IK algorithm produces. In most use cases, though, this flexibility may not be necessary, so most of the time you may end up leaving this setting at its default value. With the target rotation setting, we can choose if the target bone, in our case the hand, should use the rotation of the IK handle or the forward kinematics rotation.